Megan.
And I'm Sierra,
and we're from the Chainastics too. And welcome to Wise Wednesday.
Today we're going to be talking to you about fears in gymnastics, and a lot of people are specifically asking about fears for back handsprings or other backwards skills, which we will get to in the video because that's a huge one that people have been asking about.
But we will still be talking about other things. And the biggest thing with fears is everyone knows that they have the physical capability to do something, but then it's just like the mental thing that's holding them back.
We're also going to be sharing some of our personal stories at the end of this video, just to kind of finish off the video.
And sorry if we don't get to like your specific fear and how you can overcome it. It's all just mental, and eventually you just kind of have to get over it.
Like, that sounds kind of rude, but honestly, if you're not going to get over it, you're never going to do it anyways. So, okay, the first thing that we're going to talk about is just like, no matter what skill you're afraid of, there's so many different stuff you can do to work your way up. You don't just have to go for the skill. Make sure that at each level, like we'll show an example, each level you get completely comfortable with before moving on, and eventually you're going to hopefully gain the confidence that you need, and then at the end it's just kind of pushing yourself to actually try the skill.
And this is kind of unfortunate for, like, if you're an at-home gymnast. Like, the higher up you get, it's going to be more difficult and a lot more scary to do the skills.
But our tutorials, most of them can work at home most of the time, or you can find stuff to, like help you, I guess. If you don't have mats, there's usually other stuff. But in the end, a gym always has the most opportunities to help you.
And like, again, most people are requesting like how to get over three over back handspring and going back. The biggest thing, you just need to find the ground. Don't like get scared of the ground. The ground is your friend.
Okay? Also, the most important thing in your back handspring is to keep your arms strong. That is the most important thing there is.
I can pretty much guarantee that if your arms aren't bending, you're gonna be fine.
But also, even if they're straight, don't like turn them at a weird angle because that'll hurt your shoulder.
Yeah. So like, don't like keep your arms like completely like locked out, I guess. Like, you don't want to hyperextend your arm where it's like that.
Like, but tight. Don't let it bend.
Like, as long as your arms don't bend, you're gonna be fine.
I also wanted to say about your back handsprings, the biggest thing is just, it's just something you have to do. And if you're thinking about like hurting yourself, chances are you're going to hurt yourself because you're not focusing on how to do the skill. If you watch tutorials and you're like, I know I can do this, that's the only thing you need to be focusing on, because if you do it right, then you're not going to get hurt.
And again, if you go to an actual gym, your coaches are always going to be there to spot you. They can literally just put their hand there while you just do the whole skill by yourself.
But even if you do that and you're too scared to try it by yourself, you're not going to go anywhere, and you have to be the one to push yourself to try it harder.
Another thing is people will say, oh, I don't like bars. I just don't like it.
I don't like beam. I don't like floor. I don't like vault.
It's more specifically that you don't like a skill on that event. Like, you can't say, I don't like beam when you can't do your full turn on beam.
Also, like, by saying you don't like a certain event, whenever you go to that event, you're just not going to be in the right mindset to, like, do anything well on the event. So chances are you're going to be like, see, I don't like this event because I can't do anything right. But you're already telling yourself that you're not going to do well.
For instance, if you go to beam and you're like, it's just going to bring like a bunch of negative energy towards you. But like, if you go to beam and you're like, I don't like beam, I just can't do anything on here. Guess what? You're not going to do anything.
But if you're more like, oh, I'm not the best at my full turn, but I'll do all the other skills that I know I can do well and just work extra hard at my full turn.
Boom.
Problem solved. And then like, I guess we'll just share Sierra's story right now because it just fits in right here.
Okay, so a few of you might know that vault was not my favorite event for the past 2 years. I just kept running into it, and I don't really know why. Like, I never really had like an injury or anything. I just didn't like vault.
Just developed a fear of it.
And I don't know, like, I just kind of couldn't go over. And then last year we competed the front handspring vault, and during the meet season I think I ran into the vault twice during competition, which those didn't count for my scores because I did have like an actual vault.
But still, if you do actually go on the springboard, it counts as a vault, and she got a 0 for one of her scores, but like, she went again, so she still got
because you get two vaults at a meet. But like, just running into the vault at a meet's not really a happy feeling, and I was really disappointed. But like, since it's summer practices, to me, I think that I just don't really like the front handspring vault. I don't know why. I honestly don't know why. And the thing that helped me get over that fear was kind of changing my vault, because now during the summer, I'm working on a half on, half off. If you don't know what that is, I'm going to briefly explain it. You jump on the springboard, straight on, turn halfway in the air, and then
land on the vault, and then you turn off.
Turn halfway the other way. And I just, it's kind of more difficult, and it seems like it would be a lot scarier, but I like it a lot more. I think that, like, I don't know, but a lot of the times with your fears, if you kind of change something, since a lot of the times certain skills, like, you can kind of, they're like variables, so you can change them.
So that's Sierra's story. So don't say you don't like a certain event. Even if there's multiple skills on an event that you don't like, try just keeping in a positive attitude so you can try doing the best on that event that you can. One of my like personal fears was like, I would not do my back walkover on beam by myself because I was scared that I was going to like miss my hands and fall and hit my head, and I was just too scared to do it. And I could do it perfectly fine with someone spotting me. If someone was standing there, I could do it like basically on my own, but like I'd still like wait for them to like put their hand on my back. And in the end, I was like, I'm never going to be able to do it if I just don't do it. So Sierra helped me practice here, and eventually it's just something that I had to push myself to do. The coaches couldn't do anything to make me do it on my own. So eventually, no matter what you're talking about, your fears are going to be conquered by yourself.
Another thing, some people get mad if like their coaches aren't doing anything to like, they're like, my coach isn't even like helping me with my back walkover. A lot of the times, like, you can do it, but your coach can't do anything to make you get over your fear of doing something. Another thing is, like, you have eyes for a reason. As long as you see what you're doing and you, like, control yourself, you're going to be just fine. If you're on beam, if you just see where the beam is, put your hands on the beam, it's right there.
But hopefully we kind of covered, like, the basis of what most of you guys wanted us to tell you.
I'm sorry that didn't help you get over your fear. Again, we can't even help you get over your fear. We're just a computer talking to you.
But no matter what you're afraid of, you're the only person that can do anything about it. And you have to take the initiative to want to fix it.
And it's also kind of a pride thing. Like, you're going to be like, well, everyone else already has this, so I should probably get it.
But anyways, make sure to finish watching the rest of the videos that are coming this week. Tomorrow is going to be Tips and Tricks Thursday, so it'll be kind of a montage of the different gymnastics that we're going to do. And we also did decide what we're going to do for Saturday.
We are going to be doing Silly Saturday.